if the state cannot provide vehicles, cannot create a pool where duty vehicles will be available for members of parliament, then let us have an alternative arrangement where the government stops the deductions from MPs' monthly salaries, and then MPs are allowed to have their own private arrangement with the banks, just like other workers in the private sector do. I have not been a fan of that arrangement. I cannot understand why the state is able to create a vehicle pool for all other category of public servants. So ministers of state, DCEs, the CEOs of SOEs and other state institutions, presidential staffers, presidential aides, special assistants, civil servants, other category of public servants, the state is able to provide vehicles for them. In the case of ministers, they have cross-country vehicle and they have a saloon vehicle for their internal mobility. Why is it that when it gets to members of parliament, we have to go procure a loan? The MPs will have to be subjected to deductions from their salaries every month, which accounts for some, what, 40%, we are told. And then the state goes for a loan of 60% to supplement. This whole laborious arrangement, which becomes an extra burden to the taxpayer because you go for loans which have all kinds of terms, the interest on them and all of that, and it becomes another burden on the taxpayer. It's not the best of arrangements.